The 19th Non-Aligned Movement Summit taking place in Uganda has today entered day three, with more delegates and heads of state still coming into the country to attend. Today, a ministerial meeting attended by the majority of ministers from NAM countries, among other delegates, took place at the Speak Conventional Center in Munyonyo. The Vice President of Uganda, Jessica Alupo, officiated at the opening ceremony of this meeting. In her message, she challenged all member countries within the non-aligned movement to remove all the barriers that impede progress if they are to achieve deepened cooperation. Alupo emphasized that this can be fully achieved through supporting and facilitating regional and international trade, value addition, investment, among other areas.
That deepening cooperation is the best mutually benefiting way to create global wealth and affluence that can trickle down to all parts of the world and in turn enhance the capacities of all economies to increase global demand, create jobs for our people, and also create markets among NAM economies.
The Vice President further urged members to reaffirm their commitment to maintain unity and cohesion among member states on all issues of common interest, referring to the ongoing conflicts between Israel and Palestine.
They not only pose challenges to the core principles of our movement, but they have also caused loss of human lives, destruction of property, and contributed to the already precarious humanitarian situation around some parts of the world.
The Minister of Foreign Affairs, JJ Odong, highlighted on some important aspects Uganda is focusing on during its tenure, including strengthening international peace and security, fighting against terrorism, humanitarian crisis, and human trafficking.
Achieving meaningful results in these and many other areas will no doubt require cooperation and collaboration within our membership and other like-minded partners.
The State Minister of Foreign Affairs, Okello Oryem, told the delegates that as African countries, they are still demanding for inclusion in the UN Security Council, demanding that they at least be accorded two slots.
5% of the discussions that take place in the Security Council is about Africa. But Africa is not available as a permanent representative in the United Nations, and decisions are taken on Africa where they are not given an opportunity to express themselves. Therefore, as under something we call this, the group of countries, C10, who were formed under the auspices of the AU, to advocate and front the debate towards the reform of the UN, we have something called the Uzulini Consensus. Under the Uzulini Consensus, Africa is demanding for two permanent seats in the Security Council with veto rights. That's our position. We don't want nothing more, we don't want nothing less.
During today's ministerial meeting, members have deliberated more on ending the crisis between Palestine and Israel.
The persistence of conflicts in various parts of the world, including on our own continent, Africa, sets back our development goals.
Meanwhile, as the Non-Aligned Movement Summit progresses, the anticipated impact on Uganda's system of operation becomes a focal point, with diverse views emerging on various fronts, including infrastructure development and job opportunities. We took on the streets to analyze the public understanding of the Non-Aligned Movement Summit, and this is what they had to say.
We must thank this NAM Summit for sure. It has created this kind of independence among countries, such that countries should not go in wars which do not benefit their people.
Who believes in selling out our country in terms of tourism? It is a positive for us that guests that have come here have brought lots of money to the government.
We benefit more from these very leaders who have come from different countries. They are going to benchmark and adopt new ideas and knowledge from different countries and how things are done in those very countries.
Report compiled by Jaliat Namwaya and Sharon Nawasidi for the news.